Hello, everyone, and welcome to our weekly series of Bible readings for the coming Sunday. This week, I'm reading to you Proper 10 in Year B of our lectionary cycle. Proper 10 in 2024 falls on June the 9th. A reading from the first book of the prophet Samuel, chapter 8, verses 4 to 11, and then 16 to 20. So all the elders of Israel gathered together and came to Samuel at Ramah. They said to him, "You are old, and your sons do not walk in your ways. Now appoint a king to lead us, such as all the other nations have." But when they said, "Give us a king to lead us," this displeased Samuel. So he prayed to the Most High. And the Most High told him, "Listen to all that the people are saying to you. It is not you they have rejected, but they have rejected me as their king. As they have done from the day I brought them out of Egypt until this day, forsaking me and serving other gods, so they are doing to you. Now listen to them, but warn them solemnly, and let them know what the king who will reign over them will do." Samuel told all the words of the Most High to the people who were asking him for a king. He said, "This is what the king who will reign over you will do. He will take your sons and make them serve with his chariots and horses, and they will run in front of his chariots. Your men servants and maid servants and the best of your cattle and donkeys he will take for his own use. He will take a tenth of your flocks, and you yourselves will become his slaves. When that day comes, you will cry out for relief from the king you have chosen, and the Most High will not answer you in that day." But the people refused to listen to Samuel. "No," they said, "we want a king over us. Then we will be like all the other nations, with a king to lead us and go out before us and fight our battles." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. A reading from Paul's second letter to the Corinthians, chapter 4, verse 13 through to chapter 5, verse 1. "It is written, 'I believed, therefore I have spoken.' With that same spirit of faith, we also believe and therefore speak, because we know that the one who raised the Lord Jesus from the dead will also raise us with Jesus and present us with you in God's presence. All this is for your benefit, so that the grace that is reaching more and more people may cause thanksgiving to overflow to the glory of God. Therefore, we do not lose heart. Though outwardly we are wasting away, yet inwardly we are being renewed day by day. For our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory that far outweighs them all. So we fix our eyes not on what is seen, but on what is unseen. For what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. Now we know that if the earthly tent we live in is destroyed, we have a building from God, an eternal house in heaven, not built by human hands." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Reading chapter 3, verses 20 to 35. Then Jesus entered a house, and again a crowd gathered, so that he and his disciples were not even able to eat. When his family heard about this, they went to take charge of him, for they said, "He is out of his mind." And the teachers of the law who came down from Jerusalem said, "He is possessed by Beelzebub, by the prince of demons he's driving out demons." So Jesus called them and spoke to them in parables. How can Satan drive out Satan? If a kingdom is divided against itself, that kingdom cannot stand. If a house is divided against itself, that house cannot stand. And if Satan opposes itself and is divided, it cannot stand. Satan's end has come. In fact, no one can enter the house of the strong and carry off their possessions without first tying up the strong. Then they can rob the house. I tell you the truth, all the sins and blasphemies of people will be forgiven them. But whoever blasphemes against the Holy Spirit will never be forgiven. They are guilty of an eternal sin. He said this because they were saying, "He has an evil spirit." Then Jesus' mother and brothers arrived. Standing outside, they sent someone in to call him. A crowd was sitting around, and they told him, "Your mother and brothers are outside looking for you." "Who are my mother and my brothers?" he asked. Then he looked at those seated in a circle around him and said, "Here are my mother and my brothers. Whoever does God's will is my mother, my brother, and my sister." The Gospel of Christ. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. May you be blessed as you meditate upon these readings. I hope you have an opportunity to be at church on Sunday, either at St. George's or wherever is your place of worship. Bye for now.